Empire's Legion was discreetly transferred back to Coruscant. It was a silent trip. We all knew what was about to happen, what we're about to do. Did we have any doubts? Any private, traitorous thoughts? Perhaps, but no one said a word. Not on the flight to Coruscant, not when Order 66 came down, and not when we marched into the Jedi Temple. Not a word.
In 2005, George Lucas released the final film in his prequel trilogy for Star Wars, titled Revenge of the Sith. The film was an accumulation of all the events of the previous two films, and served the purpose of finishing the arc of Anakin Skywalker as he became Darth Vader. Whilst many people did not receive this film well in 2005, these days it has become a cult classic, and some fans even consider it one of the better Star Wars films. No matter where it ranks on your list, however, this film undeniably sets up the greatest scene in Star Wars, Order 66. Order 66 is the final act of Revenge of the Sith, and it is the order given out that the clones must turn on their Jedi Masters and the Republic turns into the Empire. During this scene, a lot of memorable characters are killed or turned, and it is a major tipping point for the universe of Star Wars, making it a very important scene. This scene has since then been replayed, and different parts of it have been shown within all different forms of Star Wars media, from Clone Wars to Bad Batch and even in games like Jedi Fallen Order, which has made a full picture of the true catastrophe of the event. Now, other than the obvious relationship to the characters we have, and the well-developed backstories between them that makes it heartbreaking, I think that this scene is truly made because of the genius of the music. Now, I know the music is certainly not the driving force behind this sequence, however I do think it plays a bigger role than most people expect, as a lot of what happens during the sequence relies on the music to carry the emotional weight, and so today I'm going to explain how the music throughout Order 66 helped to create the greatest scene in Star Wars. Starting with Revenge of the Sith and the original Order 66 scene, we have the legendary composer John Williams providing us with a few different pieces that help create the atmosphere for the scene. Starting with the actual order being given out, we have Anakin's betrayal, played as all the Jedi are one by one executed by their clone battalions. This piece of music is arguably the most important in this sequence, as it is the one that comes up time and time again in subtle sequences like the one in Fallen Order, and it is one of, if not the most emotional score for this sequence. In my opinion, this is the piece of music that makes us really care about the Jedi Order being executed. And before you call me heartless, like I wouldn't care if they were all executed without music, I suggest you go and watch the Jedi execution from Revenge of the Sith without any music. As you may notice from doing so, you actually don't really have a connection with these characters that are being killed, especially if you're watching it in 2005 before Clone Wars, because these characters didn't really get screen time or development. In actual fact, some of these Jedi's deaths are the first time we see them in the trilogy, and therefore, in actual fact, we shouldn't care if a character we never knew died. Anakin's betrayal, however, is so emotionally driven that the weight of all the Jedi's being killed makes us care as suddenly they are not individuals dying, one at a time, but instead, the music makes us see the wider picture and that the Jedi Order is dying and that the Sith are winning. This instantly then makes us sad or at least a little emotional, as in our minds, this is an unsatisfying ending of having the villains win, which nobody really wants, even though this trilogy was always inevitable. Now, why is this score so emotional and brilliant, you ask? Well, once again, John Williams is the greatest to ever do it, and so he crafted this score to hit all the emotional beats that humans need to really feel the weight of this scene. Firstly, rather than having epic staccato battle music to suggest the clones went to war with the Jedi, Williams makes the inevitability of their defeat much more apparent, as the music is much slower and legato, built around minor strings and a choir, making the music more of a funeral than a battle. Then he adds subtle French horn parts here and there to give it more of a soldier's send-off, as the Jedi are essentially executed by firing squads. As more and more Jedi fall, the music slowly crescendos, and this leads to the climax, as Yoda feels through the Force the great loss of all those he holds dear, and holds his head in pain from what he has sensed. This is important, as all the characters we weren't that attached to have died, building up the devastation that Yoda, a character we do care about, feels, and so the music builds to that as well, connecting what Yoda is feeling to us. As well as this, the big crescendo and then the falling brass brings to life the gut-drop feeling of all those Jedi's dying, and by using the powerful sound of the French horns more clearly, this signals to the audience that what is happening is important and impactful, as horns used like this are often used for things like funeral marches, or just generally for important military moments. Now, this doesn't really do justice to the emotional power of this score, however this briefly explains how the music gets us to think, and I think by John Williams using the key of A minor, and by the score subtly dulling the sounds of blaster fire and war, it creates a tragic atmosphere that is inescapable, making this piece perfect for the sequence of Order 66. On the other side of the tragedy for the Jedi, you also have the rise of the Empire in this scene. The piece of music that goes along with this is the actual theme for Order 66, which is a militaristic march used for storming the Jedi Temple. This score uses heavy drums like you would get in a marching band, and then a great deal of brass mainly focusing around the horn that is used in most military fanfares to create the feeling of a militaristic state, which is what the Empire is. Instead of the strings of the Republic, now the Empire is here in full brass, and that separates musically the two types of rule. This piece isn't played for long, however, as it is played as Anakin leads the 501st up the stairs to the Jedi Temple in a full march, and it is a great moment in Star Wars, as it is the turning point and the assault on who we would consider the good guys to be, and for this reason, the power in the music instantly draws us in, as the sheer number of troops and the power of the brass and drums make us fear the Empire and for the Jedi's lives. The theme itself is very reminiscent of the Imperial March, using a lot of the same features that makes military music so iconic. And so this theme serves as a nice precursor to an idea of the Empire we already know. This is in a much more youthful and volatile state, however, as shown by the speed and intensity of the Order 66 theme compared to the Imperial March, which is much colder and calmer, while being as menacing as possible, showing that in the early days, the Empire was waging a war, whereas later on in the original trilogy, they are simply ruling with an iron fist of fear. Whilst this particular theme isn't on screen for as long, I just think a few of the things I have mentioned there help to cement the power of what is going on, and so this really adds to the Order 66 sequence. Moving out of the realm of film and moving to the much-loved Clone Wars series, Order 66 once again makes a big appearance, and musically we are given some of the most heartbreaking Star Wars content. The piece I am referring to here is Burying the Dead, which is composed by Kevin Kiner, and it is shown when Ahsoka and Rex are burying their dead and going their separate ways after the end of Order 66. This particular part of Order 66 sequence is very different to the films, as instead of making it about the death of all the Jedis, instead it is about the loss of all the clones taken by the inhibitor chips and forced to betray the people that they cared about. The piece is incredibly simple, using synths and piano alone. However, it is this minimalism that I think is so important in this sequence. This is because throughout Order 66 so far, Williams made the music as a great tragedy for the Jedi and the grand rise for the Empire, and this led to the music being grand and sweeping, with brass, drums, strings and choirs that captured the audience in this wondrous and tragic space opera. Kiner, on the other hand, had the job of telling the story for the unsung heroes lost to Order 66, and ultimately, he had the job of wrapping up the story for the 501st Legion under Captain Rex. This meant that the music couldn't be large and powerful, as the characters weren't killed in epic fashion, and instead, Rex and Ahsoka ultimately survived, but in doing so lost a lot of their brothers. To match this, Kiner created Burying the Dead, which is an emotional conclusion to the entire of the Clone Wars in my opinion. So what makes Burying the Dead so good, if it isn't an epic conclusion like in Revenge of the Sith? Well, Kiner created a more emotional piece by using synths and light strings to create a void of sound. What I mean by this is that the theme has no defined timing or rhythm, as the synth and strings seem to go on forever without really any pattern or movement. This instantly creates a feeling of emptiness within us, as humans without rhythm and a path to follow in our music become offset, and in this case, the music is so calm and peaceful in how it neither begins nor ends that we get this very empty and lonely feeling from it. This is masterfully done to link the fact that Ahsoka and Rex have just lost so many people, and that Order 66 is such a change in their world that has left them alone, and as an audience the music includes us in that feeling. Then, from out of the abyss of synths and strings comes light and reverberated piano. Unlike with Williams, there are no horns here showing the great rise or fall of the military, and instead, Kiner uses the simple and peaceful nature of the piano to create the feeling of truly being alone, as the notes seem to appear and disappear from the void without really having a massive impact on the background. Instead, the simple melody of using single notes one at a time creates the feeling for us as an audience that what we are seeing was small and almost meaningless to the greater galaxy, and this wasn't the turning point for the world that we were watching, but instead, a small, more personal tragedy to us and the characters we loved. There isn't really much else to unpack with this piece of music, as its simplistic connection to what is going on screen is what makes it perfect. However, I think it also adds another more homely and personal emotional impact on us as the audience, and further adds to the greatness of the Order 66 sequence. So in conclusion to all of this, my point is that Order 66 is the best sequence in Star Wars across many mediums, but it owes an awful lot to the composers, as the music is a big part of its success. I know that Star Wars has always been famous for the music, but I think Order 66 is the cream of the crop for scoring, and it shouldn't be forgotten how important it is, especially when we're talking about the impact we feel when we see characters in their masses be killed that we honestly don't care about, as the music in this sequence suddenly makes them all mean a lot more to us, and the grand and sometimes the smaller tragedy of this order really sink in thanks to the music. Thanks for listening, and let me know what you think about the music of Order 66 below. Goodbye.